How are you in Silicon Valley? Because you're in it in different ways. From my point of view, we are not in Silicon Valley in San Francisco. There is no way we are in Silicon Valley. And if you went around here and you told people on the streets of San Francisco that you're so happy to be here in Silicon Valley, prepared to be in a fight very quick, except on some occasions, and that is when they're greedy and they want money, and then they will all of a sudden discover the proximity to Silicon Valley, which generates all sort of wealth. People will say in San Francisco or Berkeley, you can see my prejudice is just leaking out. They'll say things like, well, of course, you know, we know there's a lot of innovation there, but it's all technological innovation. And you kind of go, like, duh, so what? Is there a problem with it? But it's just technological innovation. I disagree with them, because I think that a lot of the interesting social and cultural innovations actually occur in Silicon Valley. I've had barbers tell me that they consider themselves high-tech workers. Why? It's just hair. They're high-tech workers because their clientele is mainly in high-tech, and the way that they get that clientele to come back is that they know how to talk high tech. But one of the ways that people take risk, there is a culture of risk taking in this area, but it's easy to take risk when you're in areas where there's an awful lot of high tech jobs. I think it's important when you're here to always remember that you're dealing with winners when you're in Silicon Valley. You're dealing with winners. Before you accuse me of standard American chauvinism, that is, shame on you. That's not what I mean. I mean something different. What I mean is that this area attracts people from around the world. It attracts really bright people from around the world.